Okay, so thank you for giving me the, this opportunity to present the talk. So the title of my talk is this lepton flavor violation in the Suji CISO model after the LHC ATV RAM. So this talk is based on the work, this work with Goto Okada and in KK and Tanaka in Osaka University and Watanabe is in IBS in Korea. So this talk is based on this work. So first introduction. So as all of you know, so a new particle is discovered at LHC and its properties are consistent with the standard model Higgs boson. Then the standard model seems to be established. However, I think it's not the end of the story. So because there are several requirements for the new physics beyond the standard model. Then we believe there should be new physics, but we don't know which scale the new physics is. So in order to explore the new physics, I think there are two ways. One way is a direct search of a new particles or new resonances. The discovery of a new particle means here it's a new physics scale or something like that. On the other hand, we can also use flavor signals as in the previous talk, and it's such kind of indirect search of the new physics gives some constraint on like this. This is a schematic view. Now this axis is a new mixing in the new physics sector, and this is a scale. So then flavor signal is flavor signal determines some combination of the flavor mixing and scale of new physics. So we hope new physics is around here. So it's a present band, and in quite near future, so both are achieved here. So we hope so. Anyway, so as we already hear about the great effort to explore this kind of new physics search in the previous talk, so it's very hard to find a solid signal of the new physics. So in this talk, we will concentrate on the lepton flavor violation. Lepton flavor violation in the charged lepton sector is a clear signal of the new physics, because in the standard model case, it's very strongly suppressed like this. And experimental efforts is like this, and now the mu to gamma branching ratio is most strongly constrained as this. And also tau lepton flavor violating process is also bounded like this. And in future, these bounds are improved in some order of magnitude. In any case, so the mu to e gamma is strongly suppressed. It should be strongly suppressed in any new physics models. So in this talk, as I said, we focus on lepton flavor violation processes such as mu to e gamma and tau to mu gamma with recent constraints like Higgs boson mass, direct search of the new particles, and some constraints from flavor signals and neutrino oscillation data. We will consider such constraints, and we will consider the Suji CISO model as a benchmark model. So I will introduce you the Suji CISO model. So there are, so though the, I'd say, it is hard to get a solution for fine-tuning problem by Suji, but there are still some good points in Suji. So then, in this talk, we will think about the Suji model, and we will introduce heavy light-handed neutrinos to the Suji model, so it's a Suji CISO model. So by introducing heavy light-handed neutrinos, so this gives a tiny neutrino mass after the integrating out the heavy right-handed Newton like this. And in this talk, we will not consider this part, but if we put a heavy right-handed neutrinos, it can be used for the baryogenesis through the leptogenesis. So I think it's quite interesting model. By the way, in the CISO models, so we introduce neutrino couplings and also we introduce heavy Majorana mass matrix. Then there are many degrees of freedoms in the parameter space. And above the CISO scale, so there are nine parameters appear. So these nine parameters cannot be determined by the low energy measurement, by the neutrino experiments. So because the neutrino experiments only approach to the this mixing matrix and this mass eigenvalues, but this gives by the combination in this form, then we have such a big degrees of freedom. And these parameters affect the prediction on the lepton paper violation or leptogenesis in the Tsuji CISO model. So let's see how it is. So in the Tsuji CISO model, the lepton exchange diagram like this contributes to the lepton paper violation process. And this is an approximation formula for the lepton paper violating decays in this type. And here we can see the off-diagonal elements of the Slepton mass matrix. And this off-diagonal elements of the Slepton mass matrix is affected by the running effect And through this running effect, the neutrino Yukawa coupling matrix contributes to the this off-diagonal element. Then this branching ratio depends on the neutrino couplings in this way. So let's evaluate the lepton paper violation in the Tsuji CISO model. So we are interested in not only the size of each lepton paper violation, but also the correlation among the different modes. For example, mu e gamma, tau mu gamma, and tau e gamma, and so on. In general, so the mu e gamma constraint is very strong. Then in Tsuji CISO model with some universal Slepton mass matrix boundary condition in such a model, so we can get such a constraint. So this line shows mu e gamma constraint, and this is a tau to mu gamma branching ratio, and this is tau to e gamma branching ratio. And only these parts are allowed. It means we cannot find the parameter region such that both tau mu gamma and tau e gamma are large. One of them can be large, but both cannot be large. So it's somehow general feature of the correlations. So, but I want to think about the how mu to gamma tau to mu gamma can be large with such a strong mu to gamma constraint. In this case, tau to e gamma should be very small. Anyway, so how large branching ratio can be obtained? I'm interested in. So let's think about that. So in this analysis, we assume the CMSSM type of the boundary condition. I mean, the soft scalar masses are universal, and the value is m0 at some high scale, gap scale. And the gauge no mass are unified to m1 half. And again, I showed the approximation formula for the branching ratio, and here, as I said, this part depends on the flavor structure in the Yukawa matrix. And this part, this is determined by the Tsuji particle mass scale. Then, branching ratio is determined by both of them. So this branching ratio depends on the two things. Now, one is the Suzy spectrum. And the Suzy spectrum is constrained by the recent LHC data. And the other is flavor structure. So let's see how the prediction is. First of all, we want to consider the constraints from the LHC-8TB run on the Suzy spectrum. So we should take into account two results. One is a Higgs boson mass, and the other is no Suzy Parkman particles, no discovery of the Suzy Parkman particles. So in the as I show later, in the MSSM, so in order to satisfy the 125 GeV Higgs bosons, the Suzy spectrum is constrained. And this means Carado Suzy particles should be heavier than 1 dB or more. Let's see the constraint from the Higgs boson mass. In the MSSM, the quadratic coupling of the Higgs bosons are not free is not free parameters. It is determined by the gauge couplings through the D-term. Then the three-level mass of the Higgs boson is not a free parameter, and it's like this. And then, in order to push it up to the 126 GeV or 125 GeV, so we need a large contribution. And in order to get a significantly large contribution by the loop effect, there are two possible ways. One is the stop is very heavy. The other case is that the left-right mixing of the stop should be large. So there are two ways. And this is a very strong constraint on the Suzy spectrum. So before going to the to show you the result of this, so I will consider the flavor sector. For flavor structure, we will consider two typical cases. One is a degenerate case, so it's a very simple case. So in this case, all the right-handed Newtonian mass are taken same. I mean the three heavy right-handed Newtonian masses are degenerate. So in such a case, so three of nine parameters becomes unphysical, then the number of the parameters are very smaller, like this. So it's a simple case. Then it's a result on in the degenerate case. So this white region is a allowed region. This gray region is excluded by the Higgs mass, and here this contour is a Higgs boson mass on this plane. So this figure is corresponding to the A term is there at a gap scale, and this figure is corresponding to the A term is minus two at the gap scale. And so they are quite different. So in this case, the Suzy mass becomes around 5 dB or 8 dB or something. And in this case, so still Suzy particle mass is right. I mean 2 dB or so. And you can see here some contours. These blue contours are mu gamma branching ratio, and these red contours are for the tau mu gamma branching ratio. As you see, in this case, this area is covered by the MEG upgrade experiments. In the case of right-handed neutrino, is heavy as 10 to 12 GeV. Then, it's like this. By the way, in the correlation among the LFP processes, so in this simple degenerate case, so the correlation is very strong because the degrees of freedom is small. So for example, if we switch off such a high energy degrees of freedom, So the correlation between mu 2 e gamma and tau 2 e gamma is very strict like this. Then there are several lines, and this and this for sine theta 1 3 is equal to 0. It's already excluded by the Newtonian oscillation data. If we take a current Newtonian oscillation experimental data, so the correlation is like this. Then we take into account the mu 2 e gamma constraint. This solid line is current bound on the mu 2 e gamma. Then the tau 2 mu gamma branching ratio can be large as 10 to 12, 10 to minus 12, or at largest 10 to minus 11. So this tau 2 mu gamma is strongly suppressed in such a simplest case. But if we switched on these high energy phase parameters, so the situation is a bit changed. So this C is one of the high scale phase parameter, and this delta is a Dirac phase, Dirac CP phase at a low energy Newtonian mixing. Then there are some regions. We can find some regions where the mu 2 e gamma is suppressed as this, but tau 2 mu gamma can be larger than 10 to minus 9. So if we switched on such a high scale CP phase parameters, we can still find such a case. So it's for the degenerate case. The second case is non-degenerate one. So non-degenerate means three right-handed Newtonians are not degenerate. So in general, there are so huge variations in this case. So then in this talk, we will consider an example like this. So in this example, the electron number is conserved in the Yukawa sector, but it's violated in the Majorana mass matrix. So mu 2 gamma contribution to mu 2 gamma is suppressed at the leading order, but it comes from the threshold corrections of heavy right-handed neutrons. Then we want to see how large tau 2 mu gamma branching ratio can be obtained with mu 2 gamma constraint. So again, we will show you the figure for the constraint on the M0 and M1 half plane. So it's almost similar to the previous one, like this. So these white regions are allowed regions. And this blue contour is for mu 2 e gamma, and this red contour is for tau 2 e gamma. You can find here, mu 2 e gamma bound is clear, but tau 2 mu gamma branching ratio can be as large as 10 to minus 9. So in future, if the nature choose around this point, in near future, MEG2 and BEL2 both find some signals on both processes. So actually, so in such a case, the correlation is not so strong. So mu gamma can be suppressed, but tau 2 mu gamma can be enhanced in such a region. Okay, I'll skip it. And I summarize my talk. And 125 GeV Higgs boson is a bit heavy for MSSM. Then we need a significant large loop contribution. And this fact constrains the parameter space of the SUGI spectra. And with the CMSSM type boundary condition, the SUGI particles become rather heavy. Even in such a case, lepton flavor violation process still have enough potential to explore the detail of the model. I mean, in near future, some signals will be found if we are lucky. So these two comments are about future tasks. So it will be interesting to study the correlation among LFVs with Baryon asymmetry of the universe through the leptogenesis. If we consider such a constraint, so how the correlation is obtained, and so I think it's interesting. And in our analysis, we choose a CMSSM type of boundary conditions for the SUSY breaking sector, but it's just a benchmark. Then, so I'm also interested in how is the result changed for the other scenarios. For example, if the dark matter abundance is considered, but without such a boundary conditions, so in such a case, so how correlations or how signals can be predicted? I'm interested also in such a tasks. So thank you very much.
New
conversion, yes.
Yeah.
So as I show in the very first part, yes, I think this comment is that experiment.
But I guess in this type of SUSY spectrum is much more suppressed. The box diagram is much more suppressed. UT conversion is
Yeah. Yes. Then, so I think in 20 years or something like that. So the expectation is like this. It is relevant to the make upgrade result. So.
Could you comment on the positive A zero?
Positive. Okay. Yeah. If so, I want to. I should point to one thing. So this A0 is a parameter at a gap scale. Then if we take a positive A0, so at the low energy scale, the left-right mixing cannot be so large. Yeah, only this sign, so large left-right mixing is obtained at the low energy scale.
Okay, if there's no more questions, let's take a speak again.